Let's talk about something interesting. Yeah? Let's up the ante. Let's get into the crux. This human existence. Let's find a really interesting topic. Interesting, interesting. What's interesting? Well, what is interesting is there is nothing interesting about anything. What deserves special praise, you see? Which topic deserves special praise? What is the top topic? You want a top topic, a middle topic, or a bottom topic? Now let's look at no topic. Can you find anything interesting in anything? If we raise the word happiness, what is interesting about happiness? Okay, maybe not a fair subject. What is interesting about politics? You see, immediately the mind goes into hard drive program, politics program. What do you know, Mr. Mind, about politics? What have I learned about politics? What is my take on politics? What do I think we, you see? Let's slip in, we can improve about politics. It's not you anymore, you see, it's we. You're speaking on behalf of the whole world. I mean, how dare you? How dare you speak on behalf of some other? There is absolutely no interest in politics. But to the mind, give me some info. Give me something interesting so that I can go and I can speak and waste my time on this earth to discuss something that is really not interesting. But it's unfair that I speak like this, you see, because there is no person really interested. And there's nothing interesting about the person. What do you find interesting about a person? You find yourself very interesting, you see. You find yourself very, very. I want to discover something about me. See? Now we're looking halfway towards truth, you see. Now, mind. There's a big division down, Mr. Mind. We have ego at this side and we have pure mind at this side. Okay, which one is he going to analyze today? Mr. Ego? Probably. And I'm going to give him everything that I know from past. Or is it pure mind? What is interesting about your pure self? Is there anything more interesting about your pure self other than your person self? Do these words mean anything? Pure self and person self. Dualistic, you see. The Bhagavad Gita says, remove truth and untruth, or remove real and unreal, or remove whatever opposites you describe this whole existence as. and remain as the transcendent. See through them, you see? See through them. Because what is in front of you is mind. The mind is your mind. Linen, thick canvas, linen. Or is your mind like a satin screen that is very easy to see through? That's all it means, you see, the Bhagavad Gita. The minute you take a side, you're looking through this side of the screen, and this side of the screen is canvas. This side has been ignored. So you say, I think politics is good. I read the Bhagavad Gita. I think politics is bad. Same canvas sheet. I see through politics. I see through politics. I see through it means you know it's not true. It's not real. Child goes to school, commits a bullying act. Goes in front of the headmaster. Headmaster says, you bullied that boy. No, sir, I didn't. I didn't bully the boy. Headmaster says, no, I see through you. You see, I see beyond you. I see beyond you, the boy. I see what your true self is trying to hide behind. Actually, it's not trying to hide behind anything. I see your true self being obstructed by your mind. There's nothing really interesting about anything. I mean, even this is just consciousness burping. Each word a burp. Sometimes coming as a fart. I'm not going to try that. A person appears to be talking, but the words that are surfacing have no gain, no purpose, no reason, no intent. Because the person's not here, you see. I want to find this person that I remember vaguely he was being. But I don't want to find him. He was really uninteresting. He was uninteresting because he didn't take your side, you see. I'm not interested in that one. He's speaking Buddhism. I want Upanishads. So therefore, no interest. Yeah, he's speaking Upanishads today. He's interesting. The one that's speaking is not interesting. The one that's listening is interested in hearing what they want to hear about a particular side. I watched a video on YouTube about a young girl. I happened to come up on the main page. I don't exist, she says, and you don't exist either. I says, wow, this is interesting. You see? But then, not really interesting. Because to say you don't exist means you're taking a side, you see? And when you say you do exist, you're taking another side. So I can see through this girl's video. But I say good on her. She's seen. So you must look beyond every video that apparently seems to be taking sides, including these ones. If you think it's aiming towards this side, delete. Because ego cannot be escaped, you will see occasions of ego appearing. The pure ones who want to remain egoless, they are very disciplined. You see, like Ramana Maharshi, Papaji, Muji. They remain in some egoless place. I'm quite happy to have ego come, but not as a name, you see. I don't want my name back. I don't want my person back. I don't want my identity back. But I like having opinions, you see. Tiny ones. Tiny opinions. That's why her video caught me. I don't exist. Yes, I like that. My advice is you find something that is really uninteresting. Really uninteresting. And see how long you can stay with that one. Find a disinterest in everything. And then find the interest in everything and see beyond them, you see? You will never experience enlightenment until you have tasted both sides fully. Fully. I am completely, completely in awe of Titian, the painter. I spent my whole life valuing this painter. He is such a great painter. And then suddenly, who is this Titian? What? I don't fully know who this name is. I don't really fully get what this form actually does. In fact, I have no interest whatsoever in this Titian. Until you can't even remember his name. Just an example. Can you do that with everything you see? That's the question. Can you value everything? Not right now, you see. You've been doing it all your life and many lives before. Up and down, sometimes valuing, sometimes being the sage. But there comes a point, not interested in anything. And then you put it to the side, you see. All the interesting stuff to this side, all the uninteresting stuff to that side. Keep them away and simply be pure. Completely as one. But beyond one, as zero.